We have worked on all the parts. Till now, we have seen all the things related to cart: deleting individual product, updating total price, updating subtotal. Now we are going to work on deleting all the products. Here we are having this href. First, I'm going to write cart.php. I will create one variable, delete all. I will save this. I will come to my project. I will refresh this one. As of now, I do not have any products. I will add two products, cart. Now, when I hover on this delete all, I am having cart.php question mark delete all. And when I click on this, in URL also, I am having same variable. I will just remove this variable. Enter. Now, whenever I click on this, all the products should be deleted. So for that, we do not have to access any ID. We do not have to use where condition. Directly, we will be writing delete query. I will copy that. And below this, I am going to write if is set. Inside this, using get method, I am accessing that variable. As soon as this variable is set, I will be writing query, that is deleting all the products. First, I am going to pass connection variable. Second, I am going to write delete query. Delete from cart. That's it, simple. Delete from cart. And after that, I am just going to relocate to cart.php. Save this. I do not have to access any variable from URL, not from database, nothing. I just have to see if this variable is set. I will write here get variable. If this delete all variable is set, directly I am deleting all the products from the cart. I will save this. Now I am having cart.php. I will refresh this. As soon as I click on this, all the products will be deleted. Again, I am redirected to cart.php. So that delete all variable has gone. And I got this message, cart is empty. And in this cart also, the number is updated. Suppose if I don't give this one, save this. I will refresh this one. I will come to shop it, add to cart, add to cart. I will click on delete all. Again, if I don't redirect it to cart.php, this variable will always be set. So for that, we are just redirecting it to cart.php. I will refresh. Now we are inside cart.php. We have almost covered everything. I will come here. Inside this, I am having add to cart. I will come to cart. When I click on this proceed to checkout, we are redirected to checkout.php. Now inside this, when I click on this, I have just simply displayed one message, yay payout. So you can work on this and you can display this page.